Futures trading involves risk and is not suitable for all investors. Content provided in this segment is meant for educational purposes and is not a solicitation to buy or sell commodities.
Hi, welcome to the glorious Upper Midwest for the October 27th edition of Basis Loaded. Basis Loaded, the weekly program that some people are calling the bomb cyclone of NDPSR broadcasts. I am Joe Schmit, joined as always by Paige Driscoll, and we'll kick off this week's report with butter. This butter number at 178.25 represents a plus quarter of a cent to the 1 week average of 177.90. Now, we traded 30 loads on the exchange, almost 1.2 million pounds traded on the exchange, and week to week the CME was up 8 cents. So on a week that you have big volume on the exchange and a sharp higher movement, you would expect lower than normal basis. Here, the fact that we were able to generate a quarter higher when our normal basis is two over, I think is still impressive. And as I said, we traded big volume on the exchange, 1.2. We're seeing that reflected here with almost 3.1 million pounds reported on the NDPSR. So all in all, I think it is a nice butter price with close to expected volume. Moving on to blocks, 182.51. That represents a plus two to the CME 1 week average of 180.65. Now, this is the high week at the CME. Typically, when, as I said, the same for butter, when we move higher on the CME, you would expect lower than normal basis. The block holding steady here at two over, which is expected basis. Also, volume, almost 12.5 million pounds, which is our normal expected volume. So far for butter and for blocks, both price and volume close to expected values. That story ends here with the barrel, 178.48. That is a plus one, a less than plus one to the CME 2 week average of 177.67. So lower than normal basis here on the barrel price, also lower than normal volume, falling well short of our 13.5 expected volume. On the barrel has rallied from 138 to 186 on the CME over the last several weeks, and the NDPSR has had a hard time keeping up with those outsized price moves at the CME. What's interesting is we have a few revisions here. Going back to the October 9th, they took that price down a penny and a half. Here on the October 16th, they revised that barrel price down a full penny. So we had disappointing basis in the barrel the last few weeks. They went back and made it a little worse, revising those prices lower. All in all, lower than expected price and volume in the barrel. On the other side of the coin here is dry whey, 55.59. That's a big move higher. When you consider that the October 9th price was 53.61. So sales here almost 2 cents over prior week's NDPSR, and the manufacturer was able to call that premium two over on big volume. Almost 750,000 pounds over the expected 4.5 million pounds. So as we talked about a little bit last week, we had a decrease in price in dry whey values. Then the spot prices ran higher. However, it takes a long time for the NDPSR to follow along to those spot values, as most of the contracts are based off prior week's NDPSR price rather than spot values. But once you get the NDPSR going in the right direction, and then you have higher than expected spot values, that's when you really get these outsized week to week moves. And moving and sales coming in at two over prior week's NDPSR and a full penny and a half over last week, certainly impressive price and volume in dry whey. And then lastly, non-fat, 138.45. That is well below, 4.5 cents below the CME 1 week average of 143. So lower than normal price here in terms of the historical relationship between NDPSR and CME. It's interesting that at the CME, week to week, non-fat prices moved up 5. And actually, this is the first of 3 weeks as the CME moves from 138 to 153. So we're having some outsized movement on the CME. on a week where week to week we moved up 5, I think it's pretty impressive that the NDPSR was able to move up 3 cents from that 135.38 to 138.45. On a 5 cent move at the CME, we moved up only 3 cents on the NDPSR. Basis went from, you know, 2 under to 4.5 under. But still, all things said, with 19 million pounds moved and at a really high price, I think that the manufacturer has to be pleased with the direction of things on the NDPSR. So here we are, week 4 or 5 for the October pricing cycle. Currently getting an October Class 3 at 1773 and October Class 4 at 1695. So we have a typical Class 3, Class 4 relationship. Going forward, if you take current spot equivalents for the November pricing cycle, current cash equivalents equate to 1883. When I left, futures were at 1884. Traders are getting a little bit too efficient for my liking. And if you take non-fat and butter prices out through the November pricing cycle, getting an October Class 4 of 1860. So that Class 3, Class 4 spread really narrows as we head into the future. Certainly a lot of milk going in the direction of cheese and cheese processing channels. It'll be interesting to see what we can expect in the weeks to come. Until then, I'm Joe on behalf of Paige. Thanks so much. Take care.